Sweet and Tender Hooligan in the House, meow. And Crab Leg comments are already there.
One was a vertical and one was a horizontal.
I'm like doing this. Yeah, don't clip that, right?
You know what would go good on these fries? Crab legs. They're just happy I'm eating on stream again, and it'll give them something to clip later. It's fine.
I love how your name is spelled as
to make awkward extended eye contact when I eat. But why is this a thing with you guys? I do not understand.
The clips.
Well, I mean, the size of this burger, I'm not sure how I'm going to eat this.
I don't... Free game on our birthday? I hope so. I don't know if that's a poor thing, but I hope so. I think so.
I hope they can stick to that, because I thought that was a really cool feature.
Honestly, as much, you know, as they've struggled over the last 2 years to get through the pandemic.
You know you're going to be in there battling COVID, baby. Kiss my ass, coronavirus bitches. We're going to be, I'm going to make that the first freaking level. You kidding me?
No, okay, so this is what I was just going to say this to kind of piggyback on what Rab said is, I think everything that was said or promised or even like the commandments, I think I don't want to say it, and once again, just me talking, and I don't work for the company, so it's just me saying this, my opinion, but I really think most of that right now is out the door. I think anything to get this in the hands of the people that paid for it and or paid for pre-orders or put money into it or have all these boxes sitting on their shelves. I think that to get this console in those people's hands and make sure that this console has longevity and new content coming after it's in their hands. Mm-hmm. I think everything else with the commandments and the birthday stuff. And I think anything that was said before they were in the situation that they are now, I think it's.
Yeah, I think like, the
once
party,
again,
I
me saying that it's out the door. Move. I don't. Sweet Tender. I don't know, man. I'm not gonna say. I'm not the company, and I'm not Tommy. But I just don't think that it's as important as to, if the system's out, and then we're talking about if we're all playing like Astro Smash and biplanes, and we're like, man, I just finished Astro Smash. Hey, what about the birthday game? I'd be like, you know what? Now's time to bring that up. Without a console even out yet, like, I don't care about the birthday game until I have it in my hand. If I have it in my hand, I guarantee you, I'll ask about the birthday game, and I'll be like, where's our birthday games?
You know, they were supposed to have a system out 2 years ago. They were supposed to have income 2 years ago. So things are a lot different today than they were back in 2018 and 2019 and 2020 when some of these things were being said. And
right. I can see the concern. Right.
But I 100% understand.
I can absolutely see the concern is people pre-ordered based off what Tommy was telling them.
I'm not blocking you for another year.
And now so many things have changed that now nobody really knows what the groundwork is anymore. So I can totally understand the frustration with it. Makes complete sense.
But no, I don't. I think everything that Tommy said is coming when everything starts, when the ball's rolling. I think right now it's manufacture, get the console out. That should be the only thing on their mind right now. Yeah, I understand, man. But like, I'm sure we're gonna see Tommy again. I don't feel that he burned us either at all.
Yeah, I
just think I think Phil's kind of handling stuff right now. You know, as far as Tommy hasn't gone anywhere. He's still, you know,
has an Amico centric fan based show. It's not holding the bag for a company. I think there's a lot of projection going on and.
So I need you guys to understand that it's a labor of love for us, but it's not just our love, it's your love too. You guys are Team Amico as much as any of us employees, because our passion is the same kind of passion you're feeling.
At the end of the day, I want this console to come out for the people who still want to have the console. I want the people who want to get their refund to get their refund. That way everybody wins. That's all I want out of this thing. I want it to materialize in a way that the people who have put money into it are happy with it. Meaning, your refund or you get your console.
Yeah.
Right.
Unfortunately, we're part of like a very very minimal percentile. We're very we're one of the few people that have played it. You know.
Sweet and Tender Hooligan. I believe we've already asked them about that before, and they are processing and doing things as quickly as they can. there is no way to do this process faster and move things along the way they want to move things along. Because at the end of the day, they still have overhead. They still have something to develop. They still have things to do. And so they're doing as much as they can when they can to try to make things right by the customer.
Yep. Yep. What he said. What he said.
I am getting.
I don't know anything of the internal workings of that. Yeah. So don't ask. I can't answer.
I'm not. And trust me, I do care about money, and I'm not one to just go, eh, whatever. But I'm gonna see what happens.
Am that guy that can.
If they're like, we're done, and this ain't ever coming, I'll see if I can get a refund.
Here's my. And this is for my own personal financial viewpoint. Yeah. So don't take this as word of law or anything.
Dude, if I could reach in my pocket and give every single one of you guys a refund, I would, but it's not my company. It's, you know, I got money in there too. I put a ton of money in hats, t-shirts, hoodies, pre-orders, 3 8 packs of games because I'm a collector. Maybe a little crazy. I've put a lot of money riding in this too. Maybe not a ton, but I mean, to me, it's a lot. I'm broke. You know, like that to me, that's a lot. Yeah.
From my standpoint, I'm already over that money. I dropped on 2 sets of the 8. I gave 1 to a friend because I didn't want him to miss out on. I kept 1 set. I got 2 consoles pre-ordered, 1 for my mom, and then I got a chance that I was going to have for myself, and then I got a chance to get a Founders. So I went ahead and dropped in on the Founders and planned to give the other one to my mom. So I went ahead and kept that one. I put that money in so long ago that financially I have fully recovered from that, and it is a non-issue for me at this point because it has been years since I put that money in. So I think for most people, if you were to look at it in that respect, I see being frustrated with it. But if you're financially strapped from that money 2 years hence, then I feel like maybe you shouldn't have put money towards the console. Because in 2 years, even with making minimum wage that I was making when I was 16, I would have made that money back in 2 years.
Yeah, so
I sometimes fail to conceptualize other than just moral outrage why it's as big a balloon as it's become. It's a problem. Yes, should people get it? Absolutely. I just don't understand the huge massive outrage on it as much as I do. Maybe it's just because I have a viewpoint on it because of my financial situation. Maybe I'm just out to touch on that. Sweet Tender Hoogland, I have lost money on things on eBay and other things where I've never gotten that money back before. I have lost money on things I have tried to purchase before. This would not be the first time, and it will not be the last time that I lose money. I accepted that when I put money into it because I knew it was a startup company. I knew there was a chance I might lose money. So I was aware when I walked in.
Right. I talked to a couple people. I don't ask them about what's going on, what's coming down the pipes at Intellivision. I know they're working their asses off. My conversation with Tommy is, how are you doing? My conversation with Phil is, hey, you got the world on your shoulders. Hang in there. I've spoken with these guys for the last 3 years, so it's like talking with some of these guys. I don't really discuss what is coming next or what is the plan and all of that stuff. We don't really have that sort of level of information that I think you guys think we are.
100% I agree, you know, that a lot of people are frustrated and stuff. Like, I wish I could help. And I see a lot of people are like, aren't you guys fed up? Like, you know, I'm
dude,
bummed
I'm
that
this doesn't come out. I'm fed up with a lot of things on a daily basis.
What am I going to do getting mad, you know?
So, Chuck, that's actually why I wanted to jump on. I'm a gamer.
I'm a gamer.
Bunch of people would be bummed out. Life would go on. But there's no sense in my pounding my fist on the table. There's no sense in my making 100 videos about, you know, why I'm upset about Amico not being out yet. There's no productivity in that.
Stan, I understand.
I have 8 collector's items for the time with the boxed items that are like little mementos that I bought because they have the coins, and those coins have some. Those coins have, monetary values. Is it $20? No. Is it something neat? Yeah. Is it a collector's item to keep on my shelf and have a memory about that has some good and bad memories? Absolutely.
It's going to be a source of negativity until they put something out. And we're here for the people who are interested in it. We're here for the people who, you know, are supporting it. We're here for the people who are critical of it. We're here to talk about the Amico when there's news about the Amico, when there's not news about Amico. We're here to talk about crab legs, about 80s food, about controllers. We're here on a Wednesday night for those of you guys that pop on.
And guys, whether you hate us or you troll us or do whatever you want, that really doesn't bother me. It really doesn't. For me, I know some people, but.
You know, it really depends on what Intellivision's actions are and how they follow through with it. If they think they have a case against Intellivision not honoring certain promises or not failing to deliver what they invested in, then yeah, they could have a case.
Other than, and I'm being serious, other than some internalized, you know, temporary making yourself feel better. I mean, what would, for us, what does getting mad and, you know, what does that do, right? What does that accomplish? It doesn't accomplish anything. So either, I mean, there's, it's funny there. This is a little more kind of black and white.
You push a political movement, a social movement. You know, I mean, you can motivate people on anger.
You can, but we're talking about video games. I mean, at the crux of
there has been a lot of video games that have been canceled or people, you know, have shut down social media accounts or walked away over anger.
Absolutely.
It has an effect in our
realm. No. I understand.
I put money. I've told a million times I put some money on that profit sharing. I don't know if that consider me an investor, and I didn't like try to float the company $1 million or anything. Like, I don't have that money, dude. I'm poor. I have more money back here than I could, but I don't want to get rid of it because it's like, I love it, you know, but I could be very well off on some of these games.
So am I frustrated it's not out? Absolutely. Would I like to see it?
Absolutely.
Yes.
Yep, absolutely.
Am I irritated we're still having the same conversation, talking about these same things for months and months and months on it? You betcha. Can I do anything to fix it? No. The only thing I can do is sit here with these guys and try to give a positive environment and try to have some fun with you guys. That's all I can do for you guys right now. And that's what I'm trying to do.
That's why we
put up with all of it. That's why we deal with the clip bait and all that stuff. That's why we deal with it. That's absolutely why we deal with it. Because at the end of the day, you guys are at least getting some fun out of it. Even if it's just making fun of us, laughing with us, laughing at us, it doesn't freaking matter at this point. But, I mean, at least somebody's here for you to talk to. Because otherwise, there'd be nobody. And what are you going to do then?
Yeah, and I was going to...
It's not out of the game. They are still...
Yeah, they were doing
something. Updating you guys 2 weeks ago that they have, you know, secured a deal. Secured a couple of deals. They told you about the one with BBG. So they are still in the fight. They are still looking forward to getting these things produced as soon as they can. Yeah. We're just sitting here, kind of waiting to see what comes next.
Comes down to it. Let me just address this really quick.
Okay, go ahead.
When it comes down to it, we're just
trying to address some other questions that came up that were directed specifically at me that I haven't had time to answer.
Oh, okay.
But I saw something coming too. I don't know what the original question was.
I was just going
to
say,
I tried to ignore you, just another viewer. I just didn't see your previous question.
Yeah, I as far as like when people were saying, you know, you guys feel like you'd be like in trouble or complicit or blah, 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 blah. I mean, I've never, if you could find a clip where I did, I've never said, hey, you guys need to do this. You guys need to do this. I'm sorry. If I was not even into this, at this point, I would be curious and probably place a pre-order. There's so much going on with Amico. I think that no matter what, I would snatch one up when you can.
There's no promises made to us. Nothing is going on. This is strictly a fan podcast.
It's just fans.
That's all
fans.
It is. As to the comments on it, on about what other people about the reviews. I've said this before. I'll say it again. I don't totally understand the massive outrage. I understand a little bit better now that you guys are saying about the promise and how money protected, etc. I get that. I also know that this company went into, holy crap, we need to survive money. And so as a rational, okay, let me rephrase it. Let me scratch rational. As a person who looks at this, I guess, as just a business trying to survive standpoint, rather than somebody who's just looking at this as just trust of money, I suspected, I didn't know, nobody said anything to me, I had no promises, no inside information on this at all, that they might dip into that money because they were trying to survive. So when it comes down to keeping the doors open and getting a product out, or keeping that money aside and completely closing the door so they can hand that money back. I
don't have one, Chris.
They were going to go with an option to keep the doors open. They were always going to do that because they're a business that wants to survive. That's how they were going to do it. I understand why you're upset. I understand why you're pissed. And you can be pissed at me if you want. That's fine. I can't fix it.
Yeah, unfortunately,
and I'm not going to sit here week in and week out and discuss this with you guys at this point, okay? I understand you are upset. I want you to get your refund. I do. If you want a refund, I want you to get it. But also understand, I have zero control over that. And so nobody here has any control over this. We can't answer it. We can't
the people
who have faster. We can't do anything with it. Take it to them. Your problem is with them. Take it to them. Try to talk to them. I can't fix it. I can't.
Oh, right here.
You guys, you have a show called Make a Fair Room, all direct contact. I am barely ever hear from a television period. Do not consider me in direct contact. If I hit somebody up from the company, sometimes I'll get a response in a week, sometimes I don't get a response at all. So most of the time, you're not going to get information from me from the company. I don't have that kind of pull at this point. They're not talking to anybody, dude. They're not even talking to us. So any information you think you're getting from anybody is probably false.
Yeah,
because they're not talking to anybody, period.
That's right.
I really want this to come out. And if it doesn't and they just end it all, I'll be like, you know what, guys? I guess you guys are right. This sucks. You know what, guys? I guess you guys are right. This sucks.
Sweet and Tender Hooligan is, I think you care about the Amico more than anybody else does right now. I'm just kidding. It's just one look, and I felt so hard, oh, hard, even
more. With you, oh, oh, I found out how good it
guys. So you know I'm positive, you know you can. I really care. That's all it took me, just one look. That's all it took me, just one look. That's all it took me, just one look. That's all it took me.
Crab legs.
A rare Super NES emulator SE developer kit, okay? Ladies and gentlemen, start opening bid $20,000. And take it down at 20. And take it down at 20. I got 15,000. Hey, but at 15, 16, 16, bid 17, 70, down at 17,000, down at here, got a detain, detain, detain. Here we go. And but at 25, but at 25, but at 25, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, twice. Fair warning, third and final call, 21,000 dollars. Sold, 20 grand, outstanding, put it on buyer number.
But I'll always dream, still I'll never own you. Making believe, it's all I can do. Can't hold you close when you're not with me. You're somebody's love, you'll never be mine. Making believe, I'll spend my lifetime loving you. Making but my happy hours I find are so few. My plans for the future will never come true. Making believe, what else can I do? Can't hold you close when you're not with me. You're somebody's love, you'll never be mine. Making believe, I'll spend my lifetime loving you. Making
Sweet and Tender Hooligan says, please say something about Intellivision Amico. It was so weird that you went to their event and liked their console. It sucked. Why? Why is that weird that I like their console?
Now, some of you may or may not know, but Steven Tyler's real name is Steven Tellerico.
I mean, are you one of those guys that's like, oh, the Amico, or, ah, Arcade? Are you like one of those guys? Because if you are, come on, dude. Like, come on. Like, look at it. Look at it from a realistic perspective. He tried to create a... Apparently it closed or failed or something. I don't even know. I haven't kept up with it. But if you look at it, like, he tried to launch a console. They kickstarted a console. COVID hit. Supply chain destroyed it. And then it just totally screwed everything. I enjoyed what I saw.
And I, whatever, if he didn't like it, then that's fine. I mean, I'm not like an apologist for Tommy or anything. People fail at things all the time. So, you know, like if you're one of those guys that's like, that's doom and gloom about the Amico or Arcade 1-Up, like this is a place of positivity, man. And if you want to be all doom and gloom, probably not the right spot. So it is what it is.
Okay. It was close.
Crab legs.
You shit your
crab legs.
You already know.
Crab legs.